Yeah, I've always wanted to do an electric record. And I think if I would have done this record 2 years ago or 10 years ago, it would have sounded like traditional country music. Because that's just kind of what I grew up in. My parents love traditional country music. And the last few years have just kind of been a metamorphosis as far as just me personally. And I really got into songwriting. And that's just kind of changed everything for me. I've always been a fan of great songwriters and the ones who just dig a little deeper with their lyrics and melodies and, you know, kind of bend the ear and the mind a little bit. And so I've always been intrigued by that. And so when the opportunity came up and I thought about doing an electric record, I said, am I going to do something that everybody's expecting from me? Or am I going to get outside the box? And so I just wanted to do something where when people hear the record, they're going to know it's me and they're going to hear some things that I have all those elements of my music or the things that I like, but also they're going to be surprised too. It's not going to be what they're expecting. And I don't think I've ever done what people were expecting. Well, I'm 38 years old, and I think most musicians, you know, in the early days, when you got the groundbreakers, when I think of the giants of the music world, the Bill Monroes, the Earl Scruggs, the Frank Sinatras, Elvis, you know, there in the early days of American music, there were all these people who were constantly creating new stuff. And the problem with musicians that came along in my time period, or newer musicians, is it's hard to not be influenced by other people. And to have your own sound without sounding like all these other folks. I want to have my own sound and create my own music, but I can't get away from the things that shape me, you know. And as a young musician, trying to find that balance of having my own sound, my own creativity, but still honoring the things that influenced me and where I came from. I think a lot of times, if you have a personality that overshadows your music sometimes, the music gets lost. And I think a lot of people kind of know me for telling jokes, inappropriate ones sometimes, having fun, cutting up and that, but they forget that I play music and I sing and I write music. And I want to be taken seriously as a musician too. And sometimes my lifestyle and my personality have overshadowed that, and that's not a bad thing. But at the same time, I also want to, you know, I just kind of want to be known for more than that. You know, I want to be known for what I can do vocally, what I can do instrumentally, and of course, you know, creatively, as far as writing the music and producing and arranging, and so. I guess this is a little more serious vibe, but, you know, I am serious about the music sometimes. My mission is to stay in the moment. My mission is to really not have a mission and to live in the moment and just enjoy every moment, because we're not promised tomorrow. Steve Sutton said something to me years ago, and I thought it was good, but now I, like, live it and breathe it. He said, as human beings, nothing's ever as good as we want it to be, and nothing's ever as bad as we think it is. And when I started, like, kind of living that in a day-to-day perspective, that's kind of the mission for me, is like just kind of keeping that perspective of, like, I want to make music, I want to be as good as I can be today, I want to show up, I want to do the next right thing for my bandmates, my family, I want to make good decisions. When I lay my head down on my pillow at night, feel good about what I've done that day. And I want to keep making music. I want to keep writing and keep doing this. Then, however it shakes out, if good things happen, awesome. If whatever, I feel like as long as I'm doing right things, good things will happen. I just have that faith, and that's a faith thing that I just have to, you know, I just got to keep doing I've got to put in the effort, and I'm in the effort business, and God's in the results business. But all those years that I tried to be in the results business, I just burn it to the ground. So I'm gonna let God do that, and I'm in charge of the effort.